Hi friends, this is Andy from TechStore, and in this video I'm going to be showing you the successor of the Dell Inspiron 3542 series of laptops. Now this is the Dell Inspiron 3543 that we have, and we can tell you one thing before the video starts, that there's absolutely no difference whatsoever between 3542 and 3543 but for the upgrade in the processor. The 3543 has a fifth generation lineup of processors, so that's the only difference. So let me show the things that have been opened for you to have a look at. Let us start with the battery here. The battery is a very standard 40 watt battery, and the power ratings are 14.8 volts and 40 watt hours. So this will give you a comfortable battery backup for around say 3 to 4 hours. And the charger is also a very standard Dell charger. It's a 65 watt charger, and the power ratings are 19.45 volts and 3.34 ampere. Even the connector has not changed, it's the same connector that Dell ships with most of the Inspiron series laptops. So we are reviewing the silver variant. There are three other variants: red, blue and black. So this is the way the top panel looks. As you can see, it's got this textured finish all over the top panel. It's got square edges, sharp cutting edges here. It's not rounded as was in 3542, so there's no major difference in the top panel also, absolutely no difference. So this is the tilt angle. As you can see, the tilt angle is not beyond 120 degrees, 100 into 120 degrees. This is the maximum that it will tilt. So this is the way the laptop looks once opened up. As you can see, it's got a glare HD LED. It does not have anti-glare. The maximum resolution is 1366 into 768. It has got two options, touch as well as non-touch. So the one that we are reviewing today is a non-touch variant, but the touch variant also will look the same, just for the difference being the screen being touch enabled. So this is the keyboard and the touch panel area up close for you. Black in color, standard Dell chiclet keyboard, full size chiclet keyboard. The 3543 is a 15.6 inches screen, and it has got a full size chiclet keyboard. It's got this matte finish. The hinges are upright, so it will seem to look bigger than the laptops which are sunk in. The touch panel area is quite huge, contrary to the touchpad, which could have been a little bit bigger than the one that they have shipped. It's a unipad basically, both right and left clicks in one touchpad itself. This is the way the left panel looks. You have the Kensington lock, charging port connector, heat dissipation vent area. There's nothing below here, the only heat gets dissipated from this part. HDMI 1.4, it's got a gigabit LAN, it's got a USB 3.0 port over here, USB 2.0 port over here. So two USB ports, one is 3.0, one is 2.0, headphone and mic combi. And this part here is entirely shiny, it's got this glossy finish, but plastic covering on it. If you remove it, it will look very shiny. The front, you don't have anything but for this power indicator, no other indicator whatsoever. There's no IO on the front. On the right, you have a memory card reader, another USB 2.0 port, and a DVD writer, and no other IO whatsoever. Not much to cheer about the base also. There are not many dissipation vent areas. As you can see, only 1, 2 and these little heat dissipation vent areas for dissipating the heat. It looks absolutely same as the 3542. The rudders are placed over here. Battery lock. In another video, we'll show you how to upgrade the RAM. The speakers are based here, over here and here. It's got Max Audio speakers branded onto it. So one good thing is you can upgrade the RAM and the hard drive very easily. In the video we'll show you that.
The camera quality is far better than the 3542. We could not find grains on this camera, and even the video was absolutely clear once recorded. As you can see, there are no wavy effects, to be precise, and it's pretty clear for video chatting. You get HD quality on this camera. Now let me showcase the audio quality for you. The audio quality is not all that great. It's pretty flat, to be precise, but does not break as such. The audio is coming from the speakers over here, as well as from here. Cannot be rated very high, but good enough for the price range. So this, my friends, was the review of the Dell Inspiron 3543. To sum it up, it's basically an affordable laptop powered by the 5th generation Intel ultra low voltage processors. This is the Intel Broadwell series of processors, which starts from Celeron up to the Core i7s. And the processor clock speeds are, as I've already mentioned, the Celeron starts from 1.5 GHz to Core i3, which is 2.2 GHz, Core i5, which is 2.2 to 2.7 GHz, and Core i7, which goes up to 3.0 from 2.4 GHz. The processors have HD graphics 5500, and for better graphic performance, you can actually take an optional NVIDIA graphics, that is a GeForce 820M with 1, 2 or 4GB DDR3 dedicated graphics. So it's basically a sort of 15.6 inches display with True Life LED backlit technology, and the resolution is 1366 into 768. It's also available in touch version, but the variant that we have reviewed today is a non-touch variant. It looks the same, as I've earlier said. It can have up to 1TB hard drive, which clocks at 5400 RPM, and it can be upgraded up to 16GB. The capacity of the processor, Core i5 and Core i3, is upgradability up to 16GB. DDR3L1600MHz memory. The output from two speakers is tuned by Waves Max Audio, and it's got a full-size spill-resistant keyboard and has a numeric pad. It's got a multi-touch gesture touchpad and offers easy navigation. The ports on this Dell laptop include a combi headphone microphone jack, HDMI 1.4a port, a USB 3.0 port, two USB 2.0 ports, RJ45 port, which is a gigabit Ethernet, a power connector. It's got a media card connector, media card reader, which supports SD, SDHC and SDXC, which is located on the right side. And for WLAN and Bluetooth, it has Dell Wireless N1705 chipset and a Bluetooth 4.0 port. It comes with Wi-Fi display enabled. It's got WiDi enabled in it, and it's got a 4-cell lithium-ion battery, which is user removable, and it's got battery backup around 3 to 4 hours. The thickness is starting from 1 inches, and the weight is somewhere around 2.3 kgs. So do let us know your suggestions and comments, and do not forget to subscribe to us. You can buy this laptop on our website, www.techstore.co.in. Thank you so much for watching, guys.